deaths by violent crime are growing in Baltimore City, and residents are fed up.
We need help as the community, I mean.
Teresa Oxidine says she's afraid.
You can't walk down the street without worrying about somebody walking up behind you. I myself, I walk, and if I have somebody behind me, I get out the way because I don't know what they're capable of.
According to Baltimore City Police data, 245 people have been murdered in Baltimore so far this year. That's up from 214 this same time last year. Another Baltimore resident says there's one way to help solve the problem.
Basically, they need more police on walking, truthfully.
But Maryland lawmakers say it's more complicated than that.
Today in Annapolis, Maryland lawmakers are here gathering with representatives from Baltimore City to address the city's recent surge in crime, even opening up the floor to members of the public to testify.
Members of the Senate Judicial Proceedings Committee and the Baltimore City delegation heard from the public and city officials on ways to solve the city's violent crime problem. Topics discussed included funding for education, youth programming, drug and mental health treatment, and job training for convicted felons. Beefing up the consequences for carrying illegal weapons was also among the priorities.
Gun violence drives crime in Baltimore. So having a conversation about it, having input from all sides is, I think, something that's been healthy for our city.
Mm-hmm. Baltimore City Police Commissioner Kevin Davis also says his officers need more resources to do their jobs well. He says that includes funding for crime labs, new license plate readers, and mobile computers.
Investments in public safety, long overdue. You
can't. Johns Hopkins professor Daniel Webster has studied gun violence for the past 25 years.
So I think resources to support the hard and difficult work that the detectives and prosecutors do to get killers off the streets really is going to be central to driving down violence in Baltimore.
We need to look at the causes and start addressing those, and the money needs to follow.
Judicial Proceedings Committee Chairman Senator Bobby Zirkin says there's plenty of work ahead.
No one bill is going to cure what's going on, and so we are here to listen. This is an
In Annapolis, Hallie Miller, CNS-TV.